चक्रवर्ती प्रभु जी, द टॉपिक इज श्रीमद भागवतम 4.7.43 ऑनवर्ड्स. हरे कृष्ण प्रभु जी, आर यू प्रेजेंट ऑन द कॉल? हरे कृष्ण, डू वी नीड टू कनेक्ट प्रभु जी?
Hare Krishna Mataji, he joins by himself. We don't have to connect him. But he has not joined yet. I don't know.
I think he accidentally left the meeting, so we should.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna Prabhuji, thank you very much.
Sorry, accidentally I got disconnected.
No problem, Prabhuji. Thank you very much. Dhanvat Pranam Prabhuji, all glories to Srila Prabhupada, all glories to Guru Maharaj. Thank you very much, Prabhuji, for giving us your valuable time and association this morning. And a very happy Balram Jayanti to you, Prabhuji. I now hand over the call to you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So we are discussing today Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 4th, Chapter 7, chapter entitled The Sacrifice Performed by Daksha. And today is text number 43. I'll just recite the text. Gandharvasu Amshamshasya Deva Marichadaya Ete Brahmendrayadaya Deva Ganarudra Purogaha क्रीडाभाण्डं विश्वमिदं यस्य विभूमन् तस्मै नित्यं नाथ नमस्ते करवामः. वर्ड टू वर्ड मीनिंग. गंधर्वा, द गंधर्वा कुचुः सेड, अंश अंशः, पार्ट्स एंड पार्सल्स ऑफ योर बॉडी, ते योर देव डियर लॉर्ड, Marichi Adaya, Marichi and the great sages, Ete, these, Brahma Indra Adaya, headed by Brahma and Indra, Devaganaha, the demigods, Rudra Purogaha, having Lord Shiva as the chief, Krida Bhandam, a plaything, Vishwam, the whole creation, Idam, this, Yasya, of whom, Vibhuman, the Supreme Almighty Grace, Tasmai, unto Him, Nityam, always, Natha, O Lord, Namaha, respectful obeisances, Te, unto You, Karavama, we offer. Translation and purport by Srila Prabhupada. Translation. The Gandharva said, Dear Lord, all the demigods, including Lord Shiva, Lord Brahma, Indra, and Marichi, and the great sages are all differentiated parts and parcels of your body. You are the Supreme Almighty Great. The whole creation is just like a plaything for you. We always accept you as the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and we offer our respectful obeisances unto you. Purport. In the Brahma Samhita, it is said that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. There may be many gods, from Brahma, Lord Shiva, Indra and Chandra, down to the rulers of the lower planetary systems, the presidents, ministers, chairmen and kings. In fact, anyone can think that he is God. That is the false, puffed up conviction of material life. Actually, Vishnu is the Supreme Lord. But there is even one above Vishnu. For Vishnu is also the planetary portion of the part of Krishna. In this verse, this is referred to by the word Amsha Amshaha, which refers to the part and parcel of a part and parcel. There are similar verses in Chaitanya Charitamrita which indicate that the Supreme Lord's part and parcel again expands into other parts and parcels, as described in Srimad Bhagavatam. There are many manifestations of Vishnu and many manifestations of living entity. Vishnu manifestations are called Swamsha, and partial manifestation and the living entities are called Vibhinamsha. The demigods like Brahma and Indra have been promoted to such exalted positions by pious activities and austerity. But actually, Lord Vishnu or Krishna is the master of everyone. In the Chaitanya Charitamrita it is said, Ekale Ishwara Krishna Arsabhritya. This means that Krishna alone is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And all others, even the Vishnu Tattva and certainly the living entities, are his servitors. Baldev is the immediate expansion of Krishna. He also engages in the service of Krishna, and certainly the ordinary living entities are serving. Everyone is created constitutionally for serving Krishna. Here, the Gandharvas acknowledge that although the demigods may represent themselves as the supreme, actually they are not supreme. Real supremacy belongs to Krishna. Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam is the statement of Srimad Bhagavatam. Krishna is the only Supreme Lord. Worship of Krishna alone, therefore, includes worship of all the parts and parcels, just as watering the root of a tree also waters all the branches, twigs, leaves and flowers. So there is a purport. I will chant the Mangala Charan and then we will start. Om Jnana Timirandasya Jnana Anjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Jena Tasmay Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamsha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunatham Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Saitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakha Vitamsa Namaham Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimade Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namini Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Pashyata Deshakare Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayade Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namine Gauruchaje Namah. He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dinabandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchina Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priya Vansha Kalpataru Vishyatrapa Sindhu Bhyayavasa Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaurav Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna. So, I think I'm speaking after almost 3-4 weeks. Like it is said that everything there is there in Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam is non-different from Krishna, and Krishna is all complete, Purnam. So similarly, Srimad Bhagavatam is all complete. Now in that, it is said that why Srimad Bhagavatam became sweet, because it was spoken by Shukadeva Goswami. Bhagavatam is like the ripened fruit. So when the fruit is touched by the beak of parrot, Shuka, it becomes sweeter. So Shukadeva Goswami spoke Bhagavatam, it became sweeter. But we are very fortunate that we got much more sweeter Bhagavatam because of the purpose of Srila Prabhupada. Bhagavatam is complete, no doubt about that. But, like Prabhupada said, I have given you everything. My books contains everything. If we just read this verse of today, see the translation, and see the purport. In the purport, Srila Prabhupada has given entire philosophy of Krishna consciousness. Entire. There is nothing which is left out there. And that is why Srila Prabhupada says, anyone who will read even one page, even one paragraph of my book, he will be liberated. Prabhupada says this. There's an audio recording about that. He'll be benefited. If we see this purport, as I said, there is nothing Prabhupada has left out. Everything what we need to understand and hear is given in this purport. Who is Krishna? What is Swamsha? What is Vibhinamsha? How Krishna expands himself into parts and parcels. So connected and separated parts and parcels. All the different expansion of Narayana are starting from Baldev. Tomorrow is Balram Purnima. I was so happy that Lord Balram's description already here. So, starting from Balram to all the Lord Vishnu's forms, and then Vibhinamsha, all different living entities, all living creatures, is mentioned in this. Also, it is mentioned how Krishna is supreme, the example is given. And what is our constitutional position? It's mentioned everyone is created constitutionally for serving Krishna. Who we are? Arsa Bhritya. That also is mentioned. Ekale Ishwara Krishna. Arsa Bhritya. So we are servants. What we have to do constitutionally, we are servants and we are supposed to serve Krishna. That's why our birth is there. We are created for serving. And with that, we will get success. And go back to Krishna. And continue our devotional service in the Vaikuntha. So, we see how Prabhupada is so merciful to all of us, to all the living entities, that his one purport, if someone reads, he'll understand what is the philosophy of Krishna consciousness. And that's why I said, entire philosophy of Krishna consciousness is summarized in this one purport. Nothing which is left out. So, we have been discussing from quite some time on this chapter about how Daksha was punished by Lord Shiva in the previous chapter, and Brahma along with the demigods went to pacify Lord Shiva, and then Lord Shiva came and blessed Daksha, and then Daksha offers the ghee or the clarified butter he offered in the fire, and Lord Vishnu appears, and how Lord Vishnu is being prayed or glorified by everyone. So these prayers are going on. Bhagavatam is nothing but about prayers. All these pastimes are there to glorify Lord Krishna in the Bhagavatam. So many times we take interest in the story, but if you see every story, it is mentioned, the incidents are mentioned, so that we know what is the real tattva, who is Krishna, and what is his position, what is our relationship. So every episode will come to the conclusion with the prayers. Either a prayer by one devotee like Prahlad Maharaj or Kunti Maharani, Bhishma Dev, or prayers by so many like demigods, all the demigods, they, you know, one by one, they pray to the Lord. and we have reached to the prayer of Gandharvas, to the prayer sung by Gandharvas. So what they said is, they're trying to say, dear Lord, all the demigods including Lord Shiva, Brahma, Indra, Maharishi are great. And the great cities are only differentiated parts and parcels of a body. You are the supreme almighty great. The whole creation is just like a plaything for you. It's like, you know, when Gandharvas, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur says, when Gandharvas came, you know, Daksha is definitely very respectful. He has been empowered by Lord himself. And then there is Brahma, there is Shiva, there is Indra, there are other demigods. We respected them. So even in even we, as ordinary living entities, we should not disrespect the demigods. We respect them because they are great. But we should know, Gandharvas, you are giving us conclusion, we should know that the greatest is Lord Krishna. The demigods are exalted because of pious activities and austerity, but the greatest is Lord Krishna. The root of this entire creation is Lord Krishna. And then Srila Prabhupada focuses on this part, how Krishna is the greatest of all. And he says, there may be many gods from Brahma, Lord Shiva, Indra, Chandra, down to the rulers of the lower planetary system, the presidents, ministers, chairman and the king. Prabhupada is so practical. He's not ending like Brahma and Shiva and Indra and Chandra. He's coming down and he uses the words, like presidents and ministers and chairmen. You know, there may be many presidents, not only the president of country, the president of a small club, the president of organization, and ministers and chairmen. And then Srila Prabhupada sums up, like he speaks the crux. In fact, anyone can think that he is God. For a conditioned soul, anyone and everyone thinks that he is God. We can say that is the eternal nature of a conditioned living entity. From the time we came to this material world till the time we go back to Vaikuntha, just before that, maybe we become completely purified, this thought will be there. Even as a sadhaka, we have so much of false ego because of this. We may not grossly say that I am God, but sometimes our activities are like that. Let me discuss on this. Now we know that everyone, including the small ant, if it is a small ant outside or inside the house, that ant also thinks that I am God and the entire creation is created for my pleasure. That's how Krishna has created everything for his pleasure. But we as a conditioned living entity, we think this entire creation has been created for my pleasure. So even the ant is thinking like that. And this is how conditioning, this is Maya's avaritma, covering shakti, avrana. Maya has put this covering and we are convinced that we are the controllers. Now even as sadhakas, we are practicing Krishna consciousness from some time, but we are not completely purified. So this thought, as I said, we may not grossly say that I am God, but we definitely exhibit time and again the quality or the characteristics of a controller. We have this controlling tendency. We have this controllership mentality. That is not different from what it's mentioned as anyone can think that he is God. The same. It's only that we are not like crossly addressing ourselves as God, but we think we are controllers. There's a tendency of every living entity. And that's why Srila Prabhupada writes in the next line. That is false, puffed up conviction of material life. That is how material life works. That is why we are conditioned souls. So how can we come out from this tendency? Our entire process of Krishna consciousness is just to take us out from this concept that I am the controller. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he explains that there are, like, everyone is envious in this material world. So envy he has very nicely analyzed in three different categories or three different levels. The first is envy against Krishna. The second is envy against Vaishnavas. And the third is envy against the ordinary living entities or other living entities, apart from Vaishnavas. So even we as sadhaka sometimes may exhibit that. Envy against Krishna, envy against devotees, envy against Guru, and envy against all other living entities. This is there. And Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur also, he gives a solution. So what is the solution? Envy against Krishna can be eliminated from our consciousness by chanting the holy name. By chanting this Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, we eliminate gradually this envy against Krishna. Envy against Vaishnava we can eliminate by serving them, by serving the devotees, by serving them prasadam, by serving what they need, by serving them, by speaking, by hearing, whatever way, we serve the Vaishnavas. And third, the envy against living entities can be eliminated by preaching to them. Because when we preach to someone, there's a compassion in our heart. And you cannot be envious of someone for one who has developed, for one you have developed compassion. These are all same feelings. They just transform. Envy is transformed into love, envy is transformed into compassion. So these three are nothing but what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Name Ruchi Jive Daya Vaishnava Seva. Our acharyas are very expert. They take the same concepts and they deeply analyze this. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Name Ruchi. So you chant, that is how you will become non-envious to Krishna. And then Jive Daya, by preaching to living entities, and Vaishnava Seva, so serving the Vaishnava. So in this purport only, Srila Prabhupada starts with this problem that everyone thinks that he is God. And in this purport, the solution is given. Everyone is created constitutionally for serving Krishna. That's why I said. And in between the position of Krishna and different incarnation of Lord, like Narayana and Vishnu and Balram and others, and then demigods and other living entities, is given. Wonderful. That's why I said everything is there in this purport. The problem, the solution and the analysis. So we should understand, like, anything we create, why do we create? Anything, like a computer, like a mobile, like a house, we create something. We create so that we can enjoy that. Now we may not create mobile, but we go and purchase the mobile. We may go purchase the laptop, we may go purchase any other thing we may need. so that we can utilize them for our pleasure. Now, devotees definitely know this concept and they utilize these things for the pleasure of Krishna. So that's all. But generally, we do anything for our own pleasure and happiness and take service from that thing. Similarly, Krishna has created this entire creation, spiritual and material, and Krishna has created us for His pleasure. One devotee once asked Srila Prabhupada, Prabhupada, why did Krishna create a material world? Prabhupada said, for enjoyment. And the devotee was like, so happy. His eyes were like shining. There's a gleaming beam. Bright face. His face became brightened up, smiling. And Prabhupada saw that, you know, that I said enjoyment. And Prabhupada immediately added, what was the question? Prabhupada, why Krishna has created this material world? And Prabhupada said, for enjoyment. And the devotee became happy. Prabhupada said, then immediately added, Prabhupada said, not for your enjoyment, for His own enjoyment. And that is why it is said in this statement, in this purport, that this material creation is a playground, is a plaything. The whole creation is just like a plaything for you. The same thing Prabhupada says. Krishna created this material world. There may be many reasons. There is another reason Prabhupada says is for His own enjoyment. In Yoga Nidra, he is in the transcendental slumber and he is relishing. And then the creation is happening. And he does so many leelas. So Krishna has created this world and us, all of us also, for His pleasure. Now, I'm coming to some conclusion that we go and purchase a mobile to give us the pleasure. And suppose when you charge that mobile, it gives you shocks, electric shocks. When you use the mobile, the other person is not able to hear you. Some functions are not working properly. So you brought that object for your enjoyment, but that you are not getting enjoyment. So what will you do? You'll immediately dispose that and get another one. But Krishna, He created us for His enjoyment. Even though we are not giving enjoyment to Krishna and we are trying to enjoy on our own, still Krishna doesn't dispose us of. He doesn't dispose us of. But kind of we are put into material world for training, for reformation. The material world is not for punishment, it is for reformation. That's compassion of Krishna, that's mercy of Krishna. So Krishna has sent us to the repair house to get repaired. What will get repaired? Our consciousness. So when our consciousness is repaired, Krishna will take us back. And again He will engage us in His own service. Why? Because that is our constitutional position. That's our constitutional position. And Krishna will be happy because we will be engaged in His service. Krishna becomes happy. And because Krishna becomes happy, we will become happy. That is the happiness formula. There is a secret of happiness formula. Don't try to become happy directly. Just try to serve Krishna, please Krishna. Once He is pleased, automatically you will become happy. And there is no other way to become happy other than making Krishna happy. So the problem is the starting of purport in the first three lines, that everyone thinks he is God, but he cannot do anything. Prabhupada writes in the third canto, in one of the chapters, Purport, Prabhupada says even the bowel movements are controlled by demigods for all of us. We cannot even control our own bowel movements. And then we claim that we are God. Nobody in the entire material world, or even no living entity, can control. We cannot control anything in our own body. No bodily function we can control. And still, the living entity gets puffed up and gets convinced. Here it's written, Prabhupada writes, that is false, puffed up conviction. The living entity is convinced that I am God. Even though he cannot control anything, he cannot control his anger, he cannot control his lust, he cannot control his greed, envy, delusion, thirst, hunger, even the movements of our eyelids, even the growth of hair on our head, even the color of our skin, even our happiness and sadness, the internal functions of our body, nothing we can control. People become paralyzed. Their hands or legs or some part of the body, you know, gets paralysis. Ask them, show the control. You think you are God? Why your body is not functioning? And Mayavadis, they say that now I am temporarily covered by Maya, covered by the illusory energy, so I am not God. Once the energy, once I will practice and go out of this covering, I will again become God. Prabhupada says you are a foolish person. If you are God, the supreme controller, how is that you are controlled by the energy of Krishna or Maya or Prakriti, whatever you say? How is that you got controlled by Maya or Prakriti if you are God? God means absolute control. So we cannot control anything in our life, and then we claim that we are controllers. So when Krishna hears what he just laughs, looking at the foolishness of conditional living entity, he just laughs. And the solution is given in the last end of the purport in few lines. That if we serve Krishna, if we practice this process of bhakti yoga, the process of devotional service, cheto darpana marjanam, gradually, steadily, this our anarthas, our heart will get cleansed of all the misgivings or anarthas. And we will become more and more fixed in Krishna consciousness. Some faith we had, and we met some sadhus. They gave us some packets of mercy. They told us how to do bhajan. The stronger our bhajan will be, the faster anartha nivritti will be, and we will be fixed up, we will become nishtha. And gradually, we will go ahead and become the premi bhaktas of Krishna, which is the goal of life, to attain Krishna prema. Then we will be really happy. Now, even though I claim that I am God, but I am not happy, because that is not the constitutional position. So when we come to the level that we will be, we'll consider ourselves, or we'll be convinced that we are servants of Krishna, and we execute, that means we perform bhakti to Krishna, that time we'll be situated in our own constitutional position, and that will make us happy. So this is the problem and the solution, both given in the purport. And then Srila Prabhupada talks about few more things in between, so we'll touch on that. Prabhupada says this above Vishnu, then he talks about how actually Vishnu is the Supreme Lord. Immediately adds, but there is even one above Vishnu. Who is above Vishnu? It's Krishna. The source of Vishnu also is Krishna, the original Vishnu. Eta chamsa kalapumsan, Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam. Vyasdev, he describes different incarnations of Krishna, and then he says, Ete, these are, some of them are Amsha and some are Pumsa. Some are part, some are planetary portion. Ete Chamsa Kala, some are Kala and some are Pumsa. But out of all these, Krishna Sutu Bhagavan Swayam. Krishna is the original Supreme Personality of God. That's why many places I have noticed that Srila Prabhupada uses in his purport about Lord Narayana or Lord Vishnu as personality of Godhead. But for Krishna, he is always the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So Krishna is the source of all the Vishnus, starting from Lord Balaram. And tomorrow is Balaram Purnima. Very auspicious. Lord Balaram is appearing, preparing for Lord Krishna to appear and also making us prepare to receive Krishna, because he is Adi Guru. Lord Balaram is Adi Guru. He has come to teach. Krishna himself expands as Balaram. And then same Krishna, Balaram and Krishna are same, the Prabhupada mentions, Balaram is teaching us. Apne Achal Prabhu Jivara Sikhai. He's Supreme Lord, but he's teaching us how to serve the Supreme Lord. So in all the forms, Lord Balaram is serving Krishna. So he's come here to play the role of Acharya, to teach us, whether in the form of Balaram or as Nityananda or Lakshman or Ananta, Shesha. He comes to teach us. So Srila Prabhupada, he said that if you want mercy of Radha and Krishna, if you want to become a part of Radha and Krishna's Leela, you need mercy of Lord Chaitanya. If you want mercy of Lord Chaitanya, you need mercy of Lord Nityananda. And that we see in the pastimes of this Dahi Chida festival. So many times Raghunadas Goswami ran away from his house, but he met Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but Chaitanya Mahaprabhu again, Allajin used to send him back. So then once he met Lord Nityananda, and Nityananda called him a thief, and he told him, I'll punish you, and you should serve all the Vaishnavas with Dahi Chida. And after that, Lord Chaitanya accepted. So if you want to be accepted by Lord Chaitanya, then you have to have mercy of Lord Nityananda. And Prabhupada said, if you want the mercy of Lord Nityananda, go and preach to the people like Jagai and Madhai. Preach to the people of this material world. And it's very easy to people like Jagai Madai in this Kali Yuga, and you will get worse than Jagai Madai also. It's easy to find out people in all over the world who are worse than Jagai Madai. If we preach to them immediately, Lord Nityananda will focus his attention on us and extend his mercy. So when we get his mercy, then we get mercy of Lord Chaitanya. And then eventually we'll be able to serve Sri Sri Radha and Krishna. So Balaram has come to teach us. His Adi Guru has come as an Acharya. And they're wonderful pastimes. And tomorrow is Sunday. Maybe some of you will go to temple, you have a lot of time. Read about Balaram in Krishna book and Srimad Bhagavatam. Wonderful pastime, discuss and float in the nectar or nectarian pastimes of Lord Balaram. And then one more point I'll just touch. So the Prabhupada says, all these demigods, the demigods like Brahma and Indra, have been promoted to such exalted positions by pious activities and austerities. So even material growth, anyone wants, he has to follow the path of Vedas, as given by Krishna. So that point also Prabhupada elaborates in many places, that how you cannot go to the moon planet or Mars planet. It's not easy. You have to perform the necessary austerities. Then only we'll reach there. But that's also given in Vedas. I thought Prabhupada has given me touch. So today we'll just sum up what we discussed is the problem. And the greatest of all the problem is that we consider ourselves as the supreme controller. And the solution is, we understand that we are not controllers, we are controlled. We are not creators, we are cooperators. Krishna is creator and we are supposed to cooperate. And our constitutional position is that we are servants. And we practice bhakti yoga by serving Krishna. We'll be freed from this disease of the conviction that we are supreme controller.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
And then we saw about how even Lord Vishnu is an incarnation of Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna is above all. And the first incarnation of Lord Krishna is Balaram, who is appearing tomorrow. So let us celebrate this by reading and hearing about Lord Balaram, praying to him for his mercy, so that we can understand our position and Krishna's position. That is why he is coming to teach us. And then practice the process given by his representative, Srila Prabhupada, who is the Jagat Guru. And by that, we will please Krishna, and eventually we will also become happy. Hare Krishna. Any questions anyone has? Anything, any comments, anyone wants to add something or questions, please go ahead.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, Dhamma Salaam, all joy to Srila Prabhupada. Thank you so much for a very wonderful class. I like that point when you said that a devotee asked Prabhupada that where this material world was created. Then Prabhupada told that this is for enjoyment. And by hearing this, we become very happy because we want to enjoy. But as soon as Prabhupada said, this is not for you, for Krishna, then it is like great understanding that it's like we all should understand this material world is meant for enjoyment of Krishna. If suffering comes, That is also the part of enjoyment, that Krishna is enjoying through our suffering. So we should try our best to make Krishna happy, not us. Thank you so very much, Prabhuji, for a wonderful lecture. So is there anybody has any question or comments for Prabhuji? Please go ahead.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, Dandavat Pranam, Augusta Shri Prabhupada and Guru Maharaj. Very, very wonderful class, Prabhuji. And thank you so much. Prabhuji, we are celebrating Balaram Purnima today. And also I have an announcement that we are having again one more class regarding Balaram, Lord Balaram. Like at 10 o'clock.
I think you are celebrating one day before.
Yeah.
It's good because the effect of Kali Yuga in America is more. So Lord Balaram is to appear there before. So
yes,
people will be benefited there.
Yeah.
Any questions anyone has?
Prabhuji, could you please tell the small pastime of Lord Balaram?
I can tell. Anyways, you have a class at 10 o'clock. But
small pastime.
Yes. So this pastime is when Lord Balaram was on the Tirth Yatra. So he went all over India to go to visit various spiritual holy places. He came to a place of Namisharanya near Lucknow. That is where Romaharshan Sutta, he was sitting, the father of Sutta Goswami, and was speaking Srimad Bhagavatam. Thousands of sages, 88,000 sages were sitting there, and they sat there for 1,000 years performing tapasya, and they all blessed Romaharshan Sutta. Actually, he is not even a Brahmana, he is Sutta. That means Brahmana mother and Kshatriya father, something like that. So, but he was direct disciple of Vyasadeva. And he was blessed by Vyasadeva also, and all these sages also blessed him. And he was sitting on the Vyasasana and speaking with the exalted subject matter of Srimad Bhagavatam. And he was blessed for long age. He was given long life. So Lord Balaram, he reached there. And all the sages, they got up and paid their obeisances to Lord Balaram, because everyone knew who is Balaram. Now the speaker may not get up necessarily, because he is sitting on a Vyasasana. He is representing Vyasadeva. So he does not need to get up of the Vyasasana. But here, even the origin of Vyasa, Lord Balaram, is coming. Balaram is not ordinary guru. He is Supreme Personality of Godhead. And Romaharshan Sutta, he didn't even acknowledge the presence of Lord Balaram. See the conditioning. Direct disciple. This pastime is teaching a direct disciple of Vyasadeva, speaking Srimad Bhagavatam. But this material world is so complicated. And immediately Lord Balaram saw this disease of false ego. He took one blade of grass, kusha grass, and he just threw it on Romaharshan Sutta, and Romaharshan died on the spot.
And all the sages and brahmanas, they are like, huge uproar. We have given him, we have blessed him, we have invested our energy in him so that he has long life and he can see Bhagavatam, but now you killed my lord, what do we do? So Balaram said, if you want, I can make him alive. But the sages were afraid because they knew he is Supreme Lord. If he has desired something, how can we go against his desire? So the sages said, my dear Lord, you are the Supreme Lord, you know everything. We do not want to go against your desire, but we also want that someone should speak Bhagavatam. So then Lord Balaram said, the father is expansion, sorry, son is expansion of father. So Roma Harshan Sutta's son, Suta Goswami, I will invest all the blessings in him. When he can, after the blessings, can sit on Vyasas and speak Bhagavatam, your purpose will be solved. So sages were happy, yes. Our purpose will be solved and Lord Balaram's desire will also be fulfilled. But then Balaram said, okay, if you think I have killed someone, I am ready to atone. You want me to do something? So they said, yes, there is one demon. And then you can, he is disturbing us, so you can kill the demon. Then Lord Balaram killed the demon. So this is the pastime given in Krishna book. And the most important is, whatever we may be, we may become guru, we may become demigod, we may become Brahma, we may become direct associate of Krishna. Krishna does not tolerate this false ego. Never. Krishna never tolerates the false ego, especially amongst his devotees. He does not like conditions, those are anyways having a lot of false ego. Even sadhakas have, but Krishna does not tolerate that. And he will do anything required to remove that false ego from our heart. Just to teach. Now obviously, the gopis and Srimati Radharani, they are exalted. They are eternal energy of Krishna. They are eternal associate, Srimati Radharani. But just to teach, Krishna is teaching us in Srimad Bhagavatam. And Krishna left them also, just to teach an example. But here we see that how Balaram has come, the Supreme Lord, he should have acknowledged, he should have stood up. So in our case also, even Lord Nityananda went to one village. I think this was the same village where Haridas Thakur was doing japa and Ramchandra Khan, he sent the prostitute. And when Haridas Thakur left the same village, Lord Nityananda also came with his associates. And Ramchandra Khan, he didn't even respect him properly, rather he disrespected them and he arranged a place for them in the cow shed, Lord Nityananda and all the associates. So here Lord Nityananda again, same Balaram and his associates were not respected properly. So whether Krishna or whether Krishna's devotee, if they are not respected properly, everything will be destroyed. So Lord Nityananda, he just laughed and he left the place with his associates. As soon as he left the place, the entire village was burned down to ashes. All the people, all the animals, all the birds, all the trees, everything was just turned to ashes. Even if one person commits offense to pure devotee or to the Supreme Lord, the entire land has to suffer. So how much careful we should be in dealing with Vaishnavas. This is Lord's teaching. And the Vaishnavas are nothing but, they are parts and parcels, but they are so close, they are in the heart of Krishna. Vaishnava stays in the heart of Krishna. So if we disrespect Vaishnava, that means we have hurt the heart of Krishna. and that itself will destroy us. So sometimes due to illusion, we may become so much puffed up. Okay, there is false ego, but we should be sensible. We should gradually cleanse the false ego. The false ego gets so much that we even start disrespecting the Vaishnavas. That is heavy. The heaviest reaction will come. So we should be very careful. Lord Balaram is teaching about this false ego. Is that okay, Mataji?
Thank you very much, Prabhuji, and you gave very good lesson as well in that pastime. Thank you very much. Is there anybody who has any question or comment for Prabhuji?
I think devotees have to prepare for Balaram Purnima and another lecture.
Okay, so let's end the call. Let's pay our obeisances to all the Vaishnavas. Vancha Kalpa Trupesha, Shubha Sindhu Bhayavacha, Patitana Bhavanevyo Vaishnavevyo Namo Nama. Anant Koti Vaishnavrinda Ki Jai, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. Thank you very much, Prabhuji, for your time and association, and happy Balaram Jayanti to all of you.